We'll start. So I would like to welcome all of you who have joined in this session. This, please let me introduce myself. Myself, Abhishek Sen. I have completed my MSc in Environmental Science, and then I have completed my MTech in Geoinformatics. After that, I have joined Datacode. Since 2016, I am working in Datacode as a technical support executive in remote sensing and GIS. So today's session is basically on the software geospatial monitoring and modeling system software TerrSet. This is the product of Idrisi. This session is for those mainly who didn't use this software before, or even who didn't heard about this software. So coming into this software, I would like to give a small introduction about the software at first. TerrSet is the product of Idrisi. Idrisi is basically formed in the lab of the Clark Labs University, which is present in US. They have basically prepared, means developed this software for their internal students initially. And when they found this is very useful to the students and their professors, they have released this software to the market and to take the advantage of the software. So previously, it was Idrisi Andres, and then they have released Idrisi Tiaga, then Selva. And after that, finally, what version we are using currently, the TerrSet, is running. So Idrisi TerrSet has released their latest version, TerrSet 2020, in just few days ago. And we are talking about this version today. So in the introduction, I have given a small line, that is a new name, a new concept, and new world of enhancers. Why this is given there? Initially, we usually use the GIS or remote sensing software for maybe for GIS analysis or maybe for image processing for our satellite imagery, for hyperspectral images, multispectral images, this type of thing. And if we have that images or we have any data, then we can go further for GIS analysis. This type of stuff can be done in the GIS or remote sensing platform. But this software has built in a way that it could help the researcher, the students, the commercial person, the industrialist to take some advantage in their regular work, in their project. That's why this software has built. So that is the part of the software, why they have built this software, why they have released so many versions. So that is the part of the software. Now, why you should be interested in this software? So that part I will cover. I'm very sure that if I ask you all that just give me a name of GIS software currently available in the market, I'm very sure you all can give a name that is ArcGIS. ArcGIS is very popular software. This is the product of ESRI. And this name is known to everyone, each and every one of us. If I ask that, could you give me a name for a software which can be used for image processing? Then some of you can give some name, some of you cannot give some name. But the most popular and available software in the market is the EDDAS. EDDAS is the software of Hexagon Geospatial, as ArcGIS is the product of ESRI, and EDDAS is the software of Hexagon Geospatial. So these are the main softwares usually we use for our daily needs in respect to remote sensing and GIS projects or remote sensing and GIS work. So why you should go for TerrSet, or why TerrSet can be useful for your work? That part can be covered in a little way today. So in ArcGIS, we are doing some of the GIS analysis work, and in ADAS, we are doing some of the image processing work. But there are some limitations in every software. ArcGIS cannot allow you to process your remote sensing images, means the satellite imagery or any hyperspectral or multispectral imagery, to process totally. Means processing means I'm telling about the filtering, foot filtering, haze reduction, pan sharpening, this type of thing. Not every option can be completed in ArcGIS. Similarly, not every options of GIS analysis can be done in ADAS imaging. Here, TerrSet is coming into the picture. TerrSet is a hybrid of these two types of software. Means it allows you to analyze your GIS data. At the same time, it allows you to
process GIS data. Data.
Sorry. Sorry. Is there any question, sir? Hello. If you don't have any question, please put your session on mute mode. And at the end of the session, you can ask me whatever you want to. Please. So here, TerrSet is coming into the picture where you can work in both the domain in GIS analysis at the same time in the image processing. So this is the main advantage of the software. Now, apart from this, what additional module or additional feature you will get from TerrSet or this platform? That I will cover. So TerrSet, apart from this advantage of GIS process, GIS analysis and image processing, TerrSet is readily giving you 6 modeler. As in the very beginning of this session, I have already tell you one thing. This is the geospatial modeling software. So it is giving you the ready modeler, 6 ready modeler to process your model, to build your model in different section. Which are those section? These are land change modeler, where you can analyze your land change, means you can prepare your land use land cover map, and you can analyze your maps, whatever the changes have been already done before few years. Means if you are analyzing some land use land cover image for the year of 2016, and you have some images, earlier images, suppose 2000 or 1990s, so you can analyze those images and you can take some decision based on those analysis. It will give you the graphical outputs, it will give you the maps. I will cover those parts later on. I will cover every single part of this software one by one. Just follow this session one by one. So land change modeler giving you this option, and the main advantage of this modeler, why this modeler is very much popular and very much useful nowadays, that is it will, besides the analytical part, the analysis part, it will give you the advantage to predict the future of the land use land cover map based on the inputs you are putting. Now you can ask how it can be predicted. So it can be predicted on that basis, that what are you putting. Means if you are giving some inputs, based on that inputs, it will prepare some models, transition models. That means it will detect some driving forces which are responsible for this transition for few years. And based on that driving forces, it will give you some prediction models. And after that, you can also check the accuracy, whether the accuracy, the prediction model is accurate or it is giving us some random prediction. You can check the accuracy as well. So these features are there, these advantages are there. I will cover all these things one by one. Just follow this session. Now, besides this land change modeler, it will give you one more modeler, that is habitat and biodiversity modeler. The researcher, the students, or the some industrial person who are working in the habitat and biodiversity section, they can use this modeler. In this section, you can work with the features, means both the features, plant features and the animal features, means flora and fauna, both can be the nature can be analyzed. And as similar to the land change modeler, you can predict some things based on your input, the why these features has been reduced day by day. Means suppose one feature is reduced in a certain area for certain years, you can try to detect the reason why these features has been reduced day by day, and you can predict some model based on that. Similarly, ecosystem service modeler is there, where you can prepare a hydropower, where you can detect some water yield, water purification.
चालान मैंने देख लिया, मैं इसको जल्दी जल्दी करवाता हूँ और उसको करवा के.
Sir, could you please?
Time लगेगा थोड़ा सा, पांच जैसे आएगा तभी आपका और ये
लोगों का. CRM sir, hello. CRM sir, could you please mute your mic?
अजी.
Could you please mute your mic? Thank you, sir. So similarly, there are R10 modeler where you can work with some time series data. Some time series data can be analyzed in R10 modeler, and the climate change adaptation modeler itself, its name says that you will work with some climate change data. I will cover this. And apart from this, there are one more modeler, that is geo series. What is that? I will cover. So what is the key feature? Excuse me, sir. CRM, sir. Hello. CRM, sir.
ये शबु शरण यहाँ का है या अंदर इस कड़े जो आती में है? हाँ. Yes.
So. The key features will include one by one all the options I will cover. As I already said in a brief, I will cover this thing. The IDRISI image processing. The one tool is IDRISI image processing. We all know if you are working with any GIS or remote sensing software, our basic step is to restore the image, means the georeferencing of that image. Until and unless I am georeferencing any image, I am unable to work with that image in any remote sensing and GIS platform. So restoration provides you the option where you can restore your image. Means you can georeference your image. After georeferencing, you have the ability to put some enhancement if required. Enhancement includes the image enhancement, that is the haze reduction, pan sharpening, putting filters, Gaussian filters, high pass filter, low pass filter. This type of filters can be put in this section. This is the image enhancement section. Similarly, there are so many options like image transformation, Fourier analysis, signature development part is that where you can put some signature, you can take the training samples, and you can finally prepare some supervised classification map. So that part can be covered in this part, signature development. After that, you can use hard classifier, soft classifier, and finally you can prepare a land use land cover map, which after that you can put in land change modeler, and then you can analyze further, or you can predict some land use and land cover change. So that is the thing. After that, if you have any hyperspectral image with you and you want to analyze those hyperspectral image, you can analyze in this platform. And finally, as I have already covered, that in every part of your model, if you want to see the accuracy of your model, accuracy of your process, you can always check for the accuracy assessment. So this all part can be completed in IDRISI image processing. Now, the second part is IDRISI GIS analysis, where you can analyze your GIS data, where you can analyze your attribute files where you can generate, analyze your additional data linked to your images. So here database query is there, mathematical operation is there. Mathematical operation gives you the permission to change your format of your data. Means if your data is in binary format, in a real data format, or in integer format, you can change those formats internally as per your requirement. Distance operation is there, where you can prepare the buffer, you can check the spatial distance. This type of options can be computed in this section. Similarly, context operation is there, statistical regression, logical regression, this type of statistical features, the statistical option is there. If you want to put any statistics in your image, you can analyze in any statistical option you can use in this section. Decision support section is there. Change and time series analysis is there. Surface analysis, where you can prepare your dame, you can prepare your contour map or aspect or slope map. This type of options can be completed in this section. Similarly, model deployment tools allows you to prepare your own model through macro modeler. You can use this modeler to put your to create your own model by putting some steps one by one as per your requirement. So next part is land change modeler. Land change modeler gives you the advantage of analyzing your land use land cover map, and after that it will, as I have already covered, it will detect the transition potential. Means transition potential means the driving factors which can be responsible for this analysis over the years, and based on these two inputs you can finally predict some changes. And after that, if the prediction, if you want to plan something that it could be for this region and I want to restrict this region so that the changes cannot be done, or I want to put this inputs, or if this type of inputs can be done. Means suppose some area is affected by deforestation for cyclone or anything, and you have detected some changes that this land has been distorted or by affected by cyclone. And if I am putting some activity like forestation, plantation, so that it can be revived as earlier condition, so that this type of planning can be done in this option. And the RED project. RED project is project. It means the reduction of emission from deforestation and forest degradation. This part can be is linked with another section of TerrSet, that is geo series. I will cover that part later. Land change, after land change modeler, as I already told, habitat and biodiversity modeler are there, where you can analyze and work with your flora and fauna data, means plant and animal data, where you can analyze the route map, where any kind of species, means animal species, is migrating over the years. You can detect this type of data. Why the sum of plant species is decreased or reduced day by day. You can analyze this type of data. This type of data can be analyzed, and this type of map can be generated in this section. This is exclusively for habitat and biodiversity. Now, the ecosystem service modeler. This is very important modeler of TerrSet, where you can do many work like crop pollination, habitat quality and rarity, habitat risk assessment. As I already covered, hydropower, marine aquaculture, water yield, water energy. You can prepare this type of models, this type of option you can detect in this section of the software, ecosystem service modeler. And the main very important advantage of this modeler is that, this is the small screenshot of the modeler where you can, where I have completed one small step. For water yield generation, it will give you the output not only in watershed level, but also sub watershed level, and even in pixel level. If you are working in any area of interest, in your area of interest, it will give you very minute level data as an output. Pixel level means you can think, you can understand that how minutely it is processing your data, and it will give you the output. Same goes for hydropower, where you can check the water scarcity for your area of interest, if anything, why the water scarcity is occurring, and what steps can be taken for facing, for meeting this issue. And this also give you the same level of precision, same level of outputs in watershed level, sub watershed level, and even in pixel level. Now the earth and modeler give you the advantage to prepare some models in respect to your temperature, sea level data, and rainfall data. Means I have already mentioned, I will again mention that this part of the section of the software will work with time series data, only time series data. Time series data, I think you all know that time series data is the data where you have the data for any phenomena like temperature, rainfall, or sea level, right, for very long years. Means you have 30 years of data for any area, and you have the data of temperature and precipitation for throughout the year for 30 long years, and you can put that data to create a model. So based on that, you can check how the climate was changing over the years. And someone is putting some lines on my slides. Please don't put that, so that other people can be distracted. So thank you. You can prepare this type of models in this section. And besides that, you can also prepare a small video, a video file, MP4 file, and show your client, show your customer, or show your end user that how the changes has been happened. You can check this screenshot, small screenshot that is I have shown you, that some of the area of the art has been modeled. I have put it only precipitation and temperature data as input, and I have created a small model. And I can also record the available video file, and I can share with you. So you can directly check how the temperature or precipitation or sea level has been changed over the years, and you can take decision based on that. Now the climate change adaptation modeler, as its name itself says, that it will work with climate change data. If you have any global warming related data, means temperature and precipitation related data, you can put those data and you can create your own scenario. That is the scenario of my area of interest, and I can further analyze the climate change effect on that area, and I can take the final decision. Besides the detecting the change of due to climate change, it also allows you to complete some crop suitability analysis in this section based on your input scenarios. Means it has already given some scenarios inbuilt in this software. That is, if you are working in cultivation of maize, cultivation of paddy, cultivation of any corn or any other kind of vegetables or any crop seeds, then you can directly check what will be the ideal condition for your area to cultivate those features. The scenario is already preloaded in the software. You don't need to pay or load anything in the software. You will directly get the option where you can analyze the suitability, whether the particular crop will be suitable for cultivation in your area or not. So this type of 2,700 species already given in in the software so that you can check your suitability of your form. Now the geo series, as I only say that I will cover this part later. That is the thing. It is related to RAID project, RAID plus project. Geo series. What is geo series? O series means open source impacts of RAID plus incentives spreadsheet, which estimates alternative policy decisions related to RAID plus projects by modeling climate, forest, and revenue scenarios. Means it is basically developed by Jonah Bass and team, a partnership between Conservation International, the Environmental Defense Fund, the World Resource Institute, and the Norwegian Agency for Development Corporation, NORAD, you can say. This feature, this option has been built by the partnership of four major organizations, international organizations, where you can estimate the alternative policy you need to take based on the RAID project. Means whatever the effect has been occurred for deforestation, forest degradation, whatever carbon emission has been increased over the year, you can estimate those things in this section, and you can take the final decision based on that. So now I can say that many of our users is currently using this software, and they are very much satisfied. They have completed so many projects, and I can give you some names who currently working in this software. These are some of our major clients who are currently using this software, which includes Geological Survey of India, who have the this is Taiga version. They have not updated their license till date, but we are working on that, and they have interest. They have shown their interest to update their license into the latest version. Similarly, Central Groundwater Board, CGWB, LNT, NIT, Tiruchirappalli, NRSC is using LCM model since 2016. Zuari Agrochemicals are there. Guru Ghasidas University in Bilaspur is there. National Institute of Engineering is there. And the BVM in Gujarat University is currently working in this software. And the last part is license and licensing part. The further details can be provided to you as per your request when you will contact us. But initially I can say you can go for the single license. If you are interested, you can go for single license. And if you are from any educational institute, you can also take the multi-seat license, where you can directly use 10 seats or 15 seats license. Similarly, educational kits are there, lab kits are there. You can take also the network license for your campus or for your lab. So that part can be provided by our sales team to you. If you are interested in procuring this software, just give us a call or send us a mail. We will provide you further details. And if you have any question, now you can ask one by one. Hello. You can unmute yourself first, and then you can ask. Okay, before completing session, you can always ask me the question. You can send me the mail. You can directly call me as per your requirement. But before closing the session, I would like to tell you something. That is, this is the very basic session of this software. After this, this series will continue after day by day. I will cover the LCM part in one session. I will cover habitat and biodiversity part in one session. I will cover ecosystem service modeler in one session, climate change modeler in one session. This series will continue after day by day. And apart from this, Datacode is also organizing the online trainings, not only for TerrSet, apart from TerrSet, there are number of software like Rockworks, versus Montage, Model Vision, Aqua, then GS Plus, Geofile. There are so many softwares are there in different fields, from geology, geophysics, hydrology. There are many softwares are there, which we are currently organizing the trainings in online mode only. So you can coordinate with us for getting the trainings. So you are always welcome. Yes, please.
Hello, Abhishek sir. This is Kavita.
Yeah, ma'am.
From Hindustan Zinc. I just want to ask the all the options which are available with that map and for discover, and we are using that. So that is that, all the features are present in this software also. Map, like you told that ARC radars both are the, this software is a combination of both the softwares basically.
Means the thing map. Is if you are working in ArcGIS or if you are working in ADAS, that means you are processing some of your remote sensing images and you are analyzing some GIS data. So this both part can be integrated and can be done in one platform. That is TerrSet for you. And as you asked in MapInfoDiscover is a totally different platform from this platform. This is basically the raster data, raster based GIS, where the analysis part is totally different from MapInfoDiscover. But these options are available with only TerrSet. If you want to ask further for this option, I can help you out. But this is totally different from MapInfoDiscover. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah,
okay. Sir, I am Rajesh Singh.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
I can hear you.
What is the cost of this software?
That part I already said, that if you are interested in this software, procuring this software, there are so many options. Means you can go for the standalone license. You can, if you are from any educational organization, you can go for multi-site license, network license, lab kit license. There are so many categories for, there. So
For standalone,
if you are interested to getting the standalone license cost, our you can send me a mail, or I am just putting your request in our concern team, and they will contact you and they will give you the further details regarding the costs.
One more question.
Okay.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Please.
Hello. Yeah, you can complete your question, then I'll ask.
Okay.
Yeah.
One more question. More question is there. Can we fuse our images like cadastral map and all those things, satellite images, all those things to this in this platform?
In this platform, you can process your satellite imagery, the cadastral map. You can put your satellite imagery, or if you have any image which we have, you have already transferred in another data format like save file or TIFF file or any PNG file, you can brought that file into this platform and you can work with.
ArcGIS we will have to keep separately, no?
No. Not
if we
No. If you are using this software and if you want to work with any other data format, you can, there is an option where you can import that format into TerrSet format. In TerrSet only, this option is there. You do not need to use other software also along with that. So, Rajesh sir, you are attending from which organization? So my team will coordinate.
I am new from Nuoco Vistas Corporation. Earlier it was Lafarge.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
Abhishek sir, I'm you have given that best solution for that, both ArcGIS and ISRI, ADAS. So I just want to ask, is there any rate variation for academic use and for professional use?
I'm just asking
because my university wants to purchase.
Definitely, ma'am. I will give you the complete answer for that. The thing is, as I told in the initial stage of my session, that the software has been built by Clark Labs University. Clark Labs University is the non-profit organization. which is not a commercial organization. So there itself, the standard license rate is very cheap than other commercial licenses available in the market. Very much cheap. I can give you a simple example. If you are going for any commercial product, I will not take the name of that product. But if you are taking any commercial product from the market, in that price, you can take 10 to 12 standard license of this product. That is the first thing. And the second thing is that if you are from any educational organization, you will get much more benefit in terms of costs.
Okay, okay. Actually, my university wants to purchase that ArcGIS. They are going for that. But now you are saying there is a benefit is there. Yeah. So I'll suggest them to purchase this software. So that's why I asked this question.
You are from which university, ma'am?
Actually, I'm an employee of Hindustan Zinc Limited. Right. But university is that Mohanlal Sukhadia University.
Mohanlal Sukhadia.
Faculty of, MLSU, Udaipur.
Okay, okay, okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions from anybody? No, if you don't have the questions right now, you can always write mails to us. We will definitely give you the answer. You can contact us through phone also. We will definitely give you the required answer to you. So feel free and keep check the posting from Datacode in our, you can follow our Facebook page and LinkedIn page where we will keep posted about our upcoming webinars. And you can also check for the online trainings, which is going on currently. And you can take the trainings from our experts also. Thank you.
Hello. Hello.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, sir. Please.
Mr. Mayank?
No, this is Hello? Abhishek. This is Abhishek.
Okay. I'm Rajshekar speaking.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Please. Go ahead.
Mayank, are you listening? I'm Rajshekar from Bengaluru.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Tell me, sir.
I put a couple of questions in the chat box.
Yes, sir. I have answered that, sir.
Could you reply at least one of that?
Yes, sir. Mr. Abhishek?
Yes.
Yeah, Rajshekar sir has asked 2-3 questions which are in chat box. If you can just cover that also.
Just let me see.
First question is...
go ahead.
How can land use... Yeah, please. Go ahead.
First question is, how can we determine the land use change along coastal line where the mining leases are very close with the impacts on backwater ingression and groundwater impacts?
Yes.
Okay.
It is a question based on my personal experience.
Right. Okay. Firstly,
in Gujarat coastal lines.
Okay. First thing is that I would like to inform you that, sir, the land change is based on the images, what you are putting, what you have with you. Means if you have the land change image for over the years for any particular area, you can put those image and based on that, it will give you the output. It will detect some driving forces, that is transition potential, and it will give you the ability to predict some changes based on your inputs only. First thing is that. Second thing is that you cannot work with groundwater data in this land use land cover section. So it is not possible to work with groundwater data in this section. So you can only work with the surface phenomena, which is available in the surface. You can work with that phenomena only.
Why I ask this question is, in the backwater region, when the ingression takes place, the soil characters will change.
Right, sir. Right, sir.
So, can we predict over a period of time?
Yeah, in that case, yes, sir, please, complete your question.
Can I complete my question, please?
Yes, sir, please.
Can we predict the level of ingression took place from the offshore inside the inland where the mining leases are situated? It is based on soil characters. I am putting because the level of the TDS in the salt waters in the sea are much more than what it is in the inland, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So can we take the ingression, that is the interface level I am talking.
Yeah.
Interface between the sweet water and the fresh water, I mean sea water interface.
No, in the land cover section, means LCM section, land cover modeler, in this section you cannot detect or you cannot analyze this type of features. But if you are interested in analyzing your changes in soil features over the years, you have to put input not the, the RGB band images from satellite. You have to put the thermal images or the infrared images. In infrared band, you can detect some changes in the soil. So you have to take the inputs from that image, and you have to put that images into the section so that you can check the changes in the soil section. But it is not possible to detect the changes for sweet water and salt water intrusion, these things in this section.
Okay, next another one which I already posted is a change detection studies are mandatory as far as the clearances are concerned for mining areas.
For mining areas,
let me complete.
Yeah.
Generally, the lessees approach the ISRO and others for doing these, carrying out these studies. Whether Datacode can take up this type of studies, and are you authorized to do so?
No, sir. Well, Datacode can able to do this type of studies if proper organization is approaching us who have the authorization, because Datacode currently.
No. See. No. Please understand my question.
Yeah.
See, I'm a lessee.
Yeah.
I have a mining lease.
Right.
While getting my environmental clearance, I have got a mandatory condition that every 5 years I have to get a change detection studies of land use pattern. So for that, generally we used to approach the ISRO and other type of organizations.
Right. I got your point.
Since you, no, please just hold on.
Okay.
Since you have this softwares and other things, you have got a capability to do so, are you authorized to do such studies? Instead of I can run to the government organization, I can run to you.
No, we are not.
Are you authorized?
No, we are not authorized. That is, I am saying, we are not authorized to do so. And sir, thank you. If you have any further question, you can directly contact with us, so that we can directly meet your question.
Now the third question I put it is, there are several freshers have approached me. They want to have a Rockworks beginners training. Can you organize a program like this?
Yeah, definitely. That part I already covered, that if you are interested in training part in any of the software, you can directly contact with us, and our concerned person will give you all the details, and our expert will organize the training.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. So, I'm assuming there's no other questions currently. If there are any questions, just write it to me or in the given mail, or you can directly coordinate with us through calls. So, thank you all. Thank you for attending. And keep attending the sessions, which will be organized within few days, and you will be posted, and you will be informed about that sessions. So thank you all.
Okay, thank you.
Stay in home. Thank you.
Thank you.